Hey guys, it's Dagan from PMTV UK, and today I have 7 basses that don't suck. Let's start with this long-legged Mac Daddy. This is the Sterling by Music Man Sub 4 Stingray Bass. Music Man have been making these iconic style basses since the late 70s, and to be fair, we sell just as much of these to beginners as we do touring and gigging musicians. These things are built like absolute tanks, have that classic Stingray sound, and aren't a lot of dosh. This guy is classic Stingray through and through. As you can tell aesthetically, it's beautiful, it looks like the big 4.5 grand numbers. It's got a lovely teardrop pickguard, the 3 one side, 1 the other side tuning pegs, 1 low noise humbucker. It is a passive humbucker, but an active 2-band EQ. So down here, there's 1 volume control, a treble and a bass control, but they're notched. So in the middle, it's flat. You can cut and boost both frequencies. That is active, so it does require a 9-volt battery in the back. It's a basswood body, got a lovely chunky maple neck, maple fingerboard. There is a choice of a rosewood fingerboard too. It comes in a plethora of different colors and also 5 strings. Some iconic music men's players are Louis Johnson, Cliff Williams from AC/DC, Tim Comerford from Rage Against the Machine, and Gail Ann Dorsey, who was Bowie's bass player, RIP. So in the intro, we heard everything flat. Let's boost some of that treble and take some of the bass back to get a nice honky Stingray kind of vibe. It's a nice chewy sound, I hope it's coming across nice on camera. Let's boost some more bass, take some of the treble back. So besides looking great and sounding great, this thing plays astoundingly. It's got a lovely smooth satin neck with a 38mm nut at the top. Not too big, not too small. Goldilocks' favourite kind of nut. There is quite a bit to hold on to with the neck, like I said. It's not uncomfortably chunk, it's just not as thin as some of the shred basses you get out there. But because of that, the whole thing resonates like nothing else. When you hit a low E, the whole thing shakes, it's great. Also, helping the fact is that the neck is screwed on by 6 bolts instead of 4, so it's absolutely rock solid. So that was a short little demo and some specs on the lovely Sterling Music Man Subray 4 bass. A lot more versatile than it looks with this one pickup. Like I said, the active 2-band EQ, you make it sound nice and brash or nice and harsh, but still retain that lovely Stingray sound. This is the Hofner Ignition Series violin bass. Obviously, the Hofner violin basses were made extremely popular by Warm Macca, Paul McCartney from the Beatles. But even if you're not a big Beatles guy, these things are astounding to play. And this is the Ignition Series, so it's the cheapest one of the bunch. And it feels like a proper violin bass as well. It's totally hollow, which is pretty insane. We've had some 5 grand Hofner basses here at PMT, and to be fair, they do feel awfully, awfully similar. This is made overseas though, not made in Germany. It's got a spruce top, a flame maple back and sides, Hofner Ignition staple pickups, a lovely wooden bridge here, and a trapeze tailpiece. Lovely C-shaped maple neck, it fits in your hand just fantastically. Rosewood fretboard, it is a 30-inch scale bass, so it's a little bit shorter. Nice mother of pearl tuners up top. And the funky control panel, which come on violin basses. Each pickup has its own volume. There's a solo and rhythm switch, which boosts the signal. When it's in rhythm, the signal is slightly attenuated. Attenuated means quietened, made quieter. And the way these work is bass and treble on. When they're on, it turns off the other pickup. So if both of these switches are on, there's no sound. So when the bass is on, it turns off the treble pickup. When the treble's on, it turns off the bass pickup. What's funky as well, when the bass is on, it adds an extra capacitor as if a tone control was turned down, so. You kind of get a lovely mellow Hofner violin bass vibe. It's a cracking thing, I can play these things for hours, they're so fun to play. They just resonate absolutely mental. Let's turn both pickups on and show what that sounds like. Ha, ah, ha, ha. Turn both pickups on so there's no sound. Let's turn both pickups off. So this is both pickups off. So makes you want to do this as well, because it weighs absolutely nothing. A beautiful, beautiful bass. So this is just the bridge pickup. I'm turning the treble on, which turns off the neck pickup. So there was some info and a few little sound bites on the amazing Hofner Ignition violin bass. Even if you're not into Paul McCartney or the Beatles, you've got to try one of these guys out because they're just so fun to play. They're so fun to even have in the living room. They're inspirational little bits of kit, and they're very loud acoustically as well. This is the East Coast P300. This thing essentially is a fantastic Fender P bass replica, both sonically and aesthetically, for just over £100. All the amenities you'd expect as well, like the lovely precision style pickups, one volume, one tone, P bass style body that comes in a variety of different colors, a lovely hard maple neck, rosewood fingerboard, four tuners at one side. It looks the business, and here are some more sounds. So this is everything all up, just like the intro. P-basses do have a very specific sound. They're not the most versatile basses in the world, but it does the P-bass thing very well. Nothing can quite replicate this. And they are very distinctive sounding, like I played in the intro. Mike Dern from Green Day uses one. Pino Palladino uses one. Two totally different style bass players, both use P-basses. Guys like Steve Harris from Iron Maiden uses one. Nate Mendel from the Foo Fighters. James Jameson and John Deacon from Queen. All very different players, all using this P-bass setup. To get the different sounds I was mentioning before, P-bass users do often ride the volume and the tone controls, and often play in different ways, whether it uses a pick like Mike Dirnt, or fingerstyle. I mean, Pino Palladino uses his thumb quite a bit. That tone down as well. This thing feels immensely stable. The neck is super comfy in your hands. It's kind of like a D shape. It is quite wide, what precision basses are known for, but there's lots of space between the notes, so you're not going to fumble over things when you're getting your groove on and whatnot. This is the Ibanez SR300E in Shoreline Metallic Burst. And right away, tell me that this doesn't look amazing. For just over £200, you can get something that looks this good and does this much stuff, which we'll get into in a second, for that price. It's crazy. Ibanez have kind of been modifying the bass guitar for the past 30, 40 years, coming on leaps and bounds with every new product lineup they have. The SR300 range has been out for quite some time, and there's a reason for that. They're bloody good. You can get pretty much every single sound out of this bass. It's got two power span dual coil humbucking pickups. They are passive, but there's an active three band EQ, bass, middle, and treble. They're notched in the middle as well. So when it's in the middle, it's totally flat. You can either cut or boost each of those lovely frequencies. There's a volume control and a pickup balancer. So instead of a switch going between the neck, middle, and well, the neck and bridge, you kind of blend the two. Very, very funky. This switch here is a power tap switch. When it's up in the top, you're only using one of the coils to get a lovely spanky sound. In the middle, it's dual, like a normal humbucker. And at the bottom, it's power tap. It's kind of Ibanez's own thing. It's a mix between the two. It's nice and spanky, but nice and full sounding. It's got mahogany body, a lovely five-piece maple and rosewood neck, rosewood fingerboard, lovely, lovely thin neck. You can get up and down this neck, no problem at all. It's lovely and light. The top horn here sticks out nice as well, so there's no neck drop or anything like that. Yeah, a nice modern spin on the bass guitar. Let's have some more sounds. So like I said, you can get pretty much every conceivable sound actually these Ibanez basses. They're used by a variety of artists such as Gary Willis, Thundercat, Stephen Bruner, and metal guys like Fieldy from Korn and Paul Gray, who was in Slipknot. So the EQ is now flat, both pickups are on. I'll show you what this power tap switch does. In the up position, like I said, the coils are tapped, so only one of each of them are firing to get a lovely spanky sound. Both them on in the middle. Comparison. And power tap is a mixture of the two, the best qualities of both. It sounds absolutely banging in the power tap mode, so I'm gonna leave it on that for the rest of the little review. I'll show you the pickups now. Let's roll on back to the bridge pickup. You can blend up to the neck pickup. So then both together. Boost some of the mids and some of the bass. Running quite hot there. Let's bring some of that bass down, put some treble in, so it's boosting the treble and the mids. Sounds pretty cool, nice and squawky. Let's cut that and boost the bass as well. Playability wise, it's a beautiful thing. Satin maple and rosewood neck, like I said. It just fits in your hand beautifully. You get all access to all 24 frets. That's two octaves. It's quite resonant as well due to the big Ibanez high mass bridge and the mahogany body. It plays as good as it looks. Look at it, man. It's mental. This is the Squire 70s Vintage Modified Jazz Bass. This guy is the 70s jazz bass of yesteryear for today's bass players. It's got a solid maple body, a maple neck, maple fingerboard with beautiful black block inlays and black binding as well. Look at that, man, it's crazy. Two Squire jazz bass pickups, a volume for each pickup, a master tone, a lovely modern C-shape glossy urethane neck with like a yellow vintage tint to it. It's awesome, open back tuners, 20 medium jumbo frets, 9.5 inch fingerboard radius. The whole thing's 34 inch scale. It's a jazz bass, it looks the business, used by guys like Jaco Pastorius, Flea, Marcus Miller, Geddy Lee. That's enough of me harping on. Also comes in a lovely shade of white. Let's hear it some more. This is the bridge pickup just by itself. Now just the neck pickup by itself. Nothing quite sounds like a jazz bass. It's the most versatile bass out there in my humble opinion, but I've actually got one of these, so I'm a little bit biased. The thing looks amazing, and for just over 300 quid, it's a Fender jazz bass. It's a Fender 70s jazz bass. Looks the part, plays the part, it's amazing. So there we have it, some specs and sounds on the amazing Squire 70s Vintage Modified Jazz Bass in natural. Also comes in white, left-handed and five string. This is the Ibanez Micro Bass in pearl white. Like I just mentioned, this is a micro bass, so it is shorter scale. I'm not just that much of a lanky streak of p***s. It's a 28 and a half inch scale to be precise, but it's not just for kids or those angry people who are vertically challenged. No, no, no. It's also good for traveling with. It's a great guitar to just pop into a suitcase or pop into the back of the truck when you're away on tour or away hiding from your family in a motel or somewhere. So it's a great bit of kit if for bass players out there that just want something fun and small to play with and you're tired of looking between your legs. It's great for guitarists, you want to add another sonic layer to their, for their recording and don't want something big and cumbersome like a normal bass. And it's also great, like I said, for beginners and kids because it's not too long of a bass. Spec-wise, it's a mahogany body. It's got a PJ pickup configuration, which means precision bass style double coils here and a jazz bass at the bottom. The P bass pickups are nice and punchy and treble sounding. The jazz pickup is a bit more mellow and laid back. There's a volume for each of those pickups and a master tone control to bring it all down. It's a mahogany body, a lovely satin maple neck, rosewood fingerboard. It comes in a variety of different colors as well, not just this dashing white one. And yeah, let's play some more. So this is all the knobs on full. Just the bridge pickup, the jazz pickup. Just the neck pickup, the P pickup. Both together. The PJ configuration is awfully popular. People like Duff McKagan have used these kind of things for years, not only for their versatility, but when they're both on, it's quite a unique sound. This is the Squire Vintage Modified Jaguar Bass, short scale. This is awfully quirky, isn't it? A Jaguar bass and a short scale Squire you shouldn't have. The Jaguar offset body not only looks amazing, but it's extremely ergonomic, paired with the short scale neck. It's a very, very easy thing to play, and very versatile, thanks to the PJ pickup configuration. So it's got a precision style punchy pickup in the middle, and a nice mellow jazz bass pickup in the bridge. There's an independent volume control for each of those pickups and a master tone control. It's got an agathis body, which is the same wood they make yachts out of. Not only that, they make lots of guitars and ukuleles out of it too. A lovely satin maple neck, very, very smooth. It's going to melt your hand lovely the more you play it. And rosewood fretboard, also comes in candy apple red. Also, it's got a matching headstock. I'm a sucker for a matching headstock on guitars. They look the absolute business. Squire Jaguar bass, it's very sleek, it's very sexy, and you don't really see them very often. Let's have some more sounds. So this is everything up, like in the intro. Let's just have that bridge pickup now. And here is just that lovely P bass, well, I guess neck pickup. But when you pair them together, you get that lovely, unique sound from the PJ configuration. So I believe this to be one of the sleekest looking cheap basses out there. It sounds good, it's versatile, and it's got a matching headstock. Look at that, skunk stripe down the neck as well. It's a remarkable little thing that I highly recommend coming into PMT and checking out, either this one or the red one. So there we have it, guys. That is what I believe to be 7 of the best cheap basses that don't suck. I don't know which one my favorite was. I do like the Squire Jazz because I have one myself, but does it look as pretty as that Ibanez? And does it feel as nice as that Hofner? I don't know, you've got to come into PMT and try them out for yourself. Whether you're buying it for yourself as an extra bass, as a knockaround, or you're getting them as a gift for a little one, or the micro bass for like I said, the vertical challenge. You've got to come in and try them out, and we'll be happy to talk you through all the options available. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar, music, and bass-related content. If you want any more info on any of the basses I've chatted about tonight, go to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding, beautiful PMT stores. Each one of our fantastic stores has its own Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook page. Be sure to like your local one or every last damn one of them, if you're feeling that nice. I've been Dagan, and I think I'll have this one in black with the matching black headstock. I'll see you next time.